Today's topic is on sudden short circuit of synchronous machine. Okay, the material which we have discussed up till now was totally based on the performance of the machine under steady state condition, that is absolute normal condition. Okay, but in practical case, the machine alternator or the synchronous motor can be subjected to transient condition. Okay, so these transients may occur from switching, sudden changes of load, sudden short circuit. That short circuit can be line to line, it can be line to ground, or all the three terminals of the machine can be short circuited. Okay, so this short circuit may develop several mechanical stresses on the armature coil, and which leads into large torque which may damage the alternator or its prime mover. Okay, so the analysis of the synchronous machine under these conditions, under this transient condition, is useful in predicting the possible condition that may result from abnormal operation resulting from short circuit. Okay, that is why we are considering here synchronous machine with all the three terminals short circuited. Okay, certain assumptions we are taking. First is the resistance is neglected. Second, machine is at no load. Third, the short circuit is occurring at the machine terminal. Okay, and power factor is the angle between EMF and armature current. Okay, and if you see this phasor diagram, okay, this is D axis and this is Q axis. If E naught is here, you can remember the phasor diagram of transformer. The flux leads the EMF by 90 degree. Okay, so this is the field flux which is leading E naught by 90 degree. Okay, and armature circuit, because we are neglecting the armature resistance, armature circuit is purely inductive. So when armature resistance is neglected, armature is purely inductive. Okay, so if it's purely inductive, it will lag the EMF by 90 degree. So this is armature MMF. Okay, this is short circuit current, that is current which is lagging E naught by 90 degree, and the MMF will be on the same line. Okay, so field MMF and armature MMF, when it is added phasorly, you will get the resultant MMF. Okay, but the point by this phasor diagram is that if the field MMF is along the D axis, the effect of sudden short circuit will be on the D axis only. Okay, that is why the short circuit MMF FA being along the D axis, its effect is seen only along this D axis. Okay, so the moment armature being purely inductive, flux linkages associated with it cannot change abruptly. Okay, so the moment short circuit happens and sudden current appears in the circuit, okay, and because of it, the additional flux will come in the air gap. This flux cannot change suddenly. Okay, and that statement is termed as constant flux linkage theorem. This theorem states that flux linkages of an inductive circuit cannot change instantaneously. Okay, so this sudden change in armature current or power factor causes change in MMF along D axis and Q axis. Okay, so there will be demagnetizing armature reaction effect in the air gap, okay, which will try to change the flux due to main field. Now the demagnetizing effect has been happening and it will try to change the flux due to main field. Okay, this change is resisted by the production of induced current in the field winding and damper winding. Now because the circuit is inductive, any sudden change will not be accepted. So point by point, the rest of the parts are helping to increase the field flux to compensate this demagnetizing armature reaction. So the first effect is there will be production of induced current in the field winding. Okay, next, the damper winding, both the windings, there will be momentary induced current, okay, which will increase the field current will increase the field flux, which will compensate this demagnetizing effect. Okay, other metal parts also there will be induction of eddy currents. Okay, so the moment there is increase in IF because of this induced component, okay, so increase in IF, increase in field excitation will result in larger short circuit current, because E naught is directly related with short circuit current. Okay, So the moment field excitation increases, the short circuit current will also be larger. Okay. So because of increase in induced current, IF is increasing. So we know that in the short circuit test, if this is IF and this is ISC, and there is a linear relationship. So if IF is increasing by induction of current in field winding and damper winding, the ISC will also increase. That was discussed in the last point. Okay, so that last point, increase in field current result in increase in larger short circuit current. Fine. Then the field poles are there on the field poles are usually fitted with damper winding. The induced current is in the damper winding also, and damper winding is also helping to demagnetize the armature MMF. Fine. So in next point, it is stating that along with the induced field current, already we have supplied the field winding with DC voltage. So this current is already present there because of DC voltage. Okay, the field current due to DC voltage is there, and one more induced field current which has been induced momentarily, it is also there, and there is induced damper bar current. Okay, these are all resulting for further greater excitation. IF is increasing, so excitation will increase. Okay, so short circuit current will also increase. Fine. So, but all this momentary induction, the field current, induced field current and induced damper winding current, these are all momentarily induced and they are not supported by any voltage source. So these effect will die out after certain period of time. Okay, so that is what written here, because these induced currents along damper and field winding, they are not supported by DC source. So this current will not be sustained for long time. Okay, they will decay with time constant. Time constant will be given by their circuit parameters, that is tau. Time constant tau is equal to L by R. L is inductor by resistance. Okay, so consequently the corresponding increase in the short circuit also decay with time constant. So the moment one by one induced current will die out, the short circuit current will also die out depending upon the time constants of damper winding and field winding. Fine. So this circuit which is being displayed, this is the equivalent circuit when the alternator is suddenly short circuited. Okay, the condition in the machine are those of three winding transformer. Okay, armature is being the primary and the secondary consists of field winding and the damper winding leakage reactance. Okay, so the effective opposition to short circuit current is offered by armature. This armature, that is XMD. XMD means what? Mutual inductance or mutual reactance of armature. Okay, and the field winding, this one is the field winding, and damper winding, this is the damper winding. The machine is working like a three winding transformer. Okay, and the net reactance which is offered to the flow of short circuit current is what we are discussing. So this is the first period, which is termed as subtransient period, which is nomenclated by double prime. Okay, so the net reactance, this is leakage reactance, this is mutual reactance, field reactance, and this is damper winding reactance. So the net reactance which is offered to the flow of short circuit current is defined as subtransient period, and during that subtransient period, XD double prime, that is D axis, direct axis reactance offered during subtransient period is XL plus the parallel of these three reactances. Okay, parallel of these three reactances. Okay, then next is transient period. Okay, transient period, right now we have discussed that depending upon the time constant, the currents which are induced momentarily will die out. So the in early circuit, if you see, there were three reactances, now there are only two reactances, that is armature reactance and field winding reactance. First, the damper winding, because of less time constant, it will die out. Okay, because the resistance associated to this current are quite large, so the time constant is very less, so the eddy current in damper winding will be absent. Okay, so XD prime, only single prime, is the representation for transient period. Okay, so the opposition reactance which is offered to the flow of short circuit current is XL plus the parallel of these two reactants. Okay, the last state is the steady state period, where the time constant of field winding is small, so it will die out. In the next circuit, there is no field winding, only armature reactance is present there. Okay, so the opposition offered to short circuit current will be only armature synchronous reactance, which is XD, that is XL plus XMD, or XMD is also termed as XAD. Okay, so if you see all the three reactants, the XD double dash, that is subtransient reactance, then this is transient state reactance, and this is steady state reactance, XD is larger than XD dash, because here there are three reactants which are in parallel, so the net reactance becomes less. Here are only two reactants which are in parallel, so XD dash will be greater than XD double dash, and XD dash and XD will be greater than XD dash. Okay, if you see the values properly, so this is the relation. Okay, so in XD, that is steady state period, more opposition is offered to short circuit current. Okay, if this is the scene with the reactances in different periods, then short circuit current during subtransient period will be larger than short circuit current in transient period. Okay, and in steady state period, the short circuit current will be the least. Okay, the machine will come under stable condition at this period. Okay, so these are the impedance which are offered by the machine itself to this unstable or abnormal condition. Fine, so this is the relation related with short circuit. Fine, least current is short circuit and largest is the subtransient period. This is the largest short circuit current. This is the oscillogram of short circuit current. Okay, so this is the profile of only AC component. So from this point to this point, it is subtransient period, and from this point to this point, it is transient period, and this point is further, it is steady state period, where you can see that the current is becoming stable and it is least. Right now we have discussed that during subtransient period, the short circuit current will be largest, so it is largest. Further, in transient period, the short circuit current is less than subtransient period, and in steady state, the short circuit current is the least one, because maximum opposition is offered during steady state period. Fine, so if you extrapolate this waveform, so you get a point. So this capital OA is the peak value of current, short circuit current, during subtransient period. Okay, so IA double prime, that is armature current during subtransient period, is equal to OA by root 2. OA is the peak value. Okay, so XD double dash, that is the DXS reactance which is offered during subtransient period, will be equal to voltage divided by this IA double prime. Okay, this is the magnitude of reactance which is offered during subtransient period. Okay, if transient period has been extrapolated backward side along the y axis, you get a B point. Okay, so OB is the current, peak value of current during transient period. So IA prime is representation for transient. Okay, so IA prime is equal to OB by root 2. Okay, so XD dash is equal to E by IA prime. Fine, the third period is the steady state period. If you extrapolate this waveform backside, you get point C. Okay, so OC, so steady state current, it is not represented by any prime. Okay, simple IA. Okay, so IA is equal to OC by root 2, that is the steady state current. Okay, so steady state reactance XD is equal to voltage by IA. Okay, so this is the machine behavior during transient state. Whenever any transient state will happen to the machine, this is the performance of the machine, which machine itself giving without any external components. Fine, okay, that's all.